physically from a George Halani to have that type of season, being the feature bell cow back?
You talk about the mental aspect. I think just the way he attacked the offseason, from when we started up in January to where we are, he had his mind made up. He wanted to be a guy that was dependable. We talked about just the history of what has come out the running back room here at Boise State. So I think if you ask me, it's the mentality, first of all. And then, as he kind of went through the summer, he did a great job not only leading the group, but being a leader on the team. And I think, for him, being able to have that kind of presence on the team as well as in offense is exactly what you're talking about being a guy that can go out there play after play, knowing that, he has a room, he has a team, the whole offense depending on him to go out there. From a coaching standpoint, it's getting him prepped, physically, through the course of practice, through the course of, making sure his mindset is right, he's away from the football field, where he's doing maintenance and those type of things, keep his body ready to go every time he touches the field.
It's common sense, but having George Halani where you can play him as much as you want, and I know you weren't here last year, but they said, we can only play him 15 plays this game, 20 plays this game. To what is a full strength unleashed George Halani? How exciting is that to what he could do for this offense?
Like you said, I wasn't here last year, but I do know this. I mean, over the course of spring ball and to where we've been through fall camp, leading into this week, being able to keep him on the field as much as possible would be really beneficial for the offense, for the team as a whole. And then you look at his opportunities last year when he did play a lot of the games. The results, the production for the offense was really high. So it definitely is exciting, for us as a coaching staff and for the team as a whole. And that's the cool thing about George. He's a big-time team player. He's always willing to pass the credit. But at the same time, he knows how important it is for him to be ready to play, play after play.
Your first time broadcast, when it comes to not having a cloud on his account or anything taking over his head, play free, not worried about any of that stuff. How much does that free your mind to go out and play?
Obviously, I never talked to him about the pitch count thing.
Kind of got his mindset there, but I will say this: I think in his mind he's ready to go,
and that's the most important thing. Going back to, like I said, the mentality piece. He feels that he can go, that builds confidence in how he attacks each play, that builds confidence how he attacks the meeting room, how he attacks his maintenance, how he attacks everything, because he knows he feels like he's 100% ready. He's a really good player. He's definitely very talented. He does some really good things with the ball in his hand. I would say, going into spring ball, you weren't sure what to expect, and then you got excited for the potential. I think going into fall camp, you prepared yourself to go through a first fall camp, during the time you really should have still been in high school when he was working out during the wintertime. And, obviously going into the season is a lot different. This is going to be this is his first trip game week. This is his first game as a college football player. So, it's going to be interesting to see how he adjusts. Just continue to bring confidence and continue to develop and bring him along. Now to say, he's exceeded expectations, I wouldn't say that. I just, we weren't sure what we had. And, he's continued to build and grow. So I'm excited to see what that means.
What nuances or little things are you trying to get Ashton to pick up on?
He's been here 7 months, eight months, or whatever it is. So he needs to pick up on everything. Just, the style of running, his style of running the ball, what it means to truly be in protection, what it means to study, what it means to, go to class, what it means to, take care of your body when you're not out there on the football field. So there's so many things that,
we are continually trying to build. But what you got to try to do for a kid like him, being brand new here, is just compartmentalize it for him. So it's one step at a time, so he's not drinking out of the fire hose.
As we all know, it's a growing process, and you just got to be careful not putting too many expectations on a young kid, but continue to breed self-confidence and self-esteem in him so he can continue to be productive, not over the course of one or two games, but over the course of his career here at Boise State.
You
guys only listed, you know, Ashton and George on the depth chart that came out. So what how do you envision beyond that to be in terms of those guys getting any kind of, you know, significant action, I guess?
You know, I don't know if that's an easy question to answer. I will say this. I feel good about the talent in our room. You know, we have, you know, guys like Tyler Crow, Thad O'Noah, Kate Dudley, who moved over as well. Those guys will be getting some reps. I'd say how they are going to work into the game plan. I couldn't tell you that right now. But I'm confident with the depth that we're trying to build in our room, and I'm excited to see this room go over the course of the season.
You got your starting bell cow back, also returning punts. The special teams coach, too. He's just so good winning that job. And he just said, you know what, any type of risk that comes with him returning punts, we're going to take it because he's so darn good at it.
I guess he's just better than everybody else that was there. No.
Did Gaskin return punts in Seattle? Like, have you done that before?
You know, I will say this. I think when it comes to our punt return team, it's always going to come back to getting the ball back to the offense. And we're trying to put the guys back there and the guys on the field that we feel the most confident that's going to get the ball back to the offense, whether it be after an explosive return. Hopefully, it's a return all the way to the house, and then we can get the kickoff team ready. But at the same time, you know, as you guys know, with the questions that you guys started with, we have a lot of faith and confidence in what George can do. He is one of those guys that's dependable, consistent, so that's what we feel excited about him being back there.
Yeah, it's a guy like Caden. We haven't, you know, seen a ton of him in practice, but when we do, he fits into the running back room. He doesn't look like a wide receiver, you know, trying to play running back. What have you seen out of him? Has he made the smooth, he moved pretty smoothly?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I think, you know, coming from the receiver room, he brings, at an element, he knows how to run routes and catch the ball decently. I think, you know, obviously him still, he's a redshirt freshman or whatever, so he's a young guy too. And I think, you know, even with him, you know, you're just trying to get him to have confidence in the position. And, you know, the things that are always going to come up, you know, ball security, posture, you know, your fundamentals of how you can change directions with the ball in your hand and the pass protection for all these guys. And, you know, him being so new to the position, he has a lot to build on, but athleticism and the way that he wants to learn, I'm excited for what he can do here.
What are you seeing from Oregon State's defense?
You know, really good defense. I think they play sound defense. I think, you know, one of the things that they try to do is keep you behind the sticks, which most defenses do, but they have a solid scheme, and I think they do a good job of staying within the element of what they're good at. They seem not to get frazzled out there, and obviously it's a team with some veteran players out there that have been in these games and understand what it means to start off the season fresh. And I know, obviously, I've known Coach Smith for a long time, so we'll have that team and that defense ready, so we're excited.
You have the familiarity with Oregon State for the past couple of years. Is there been any extra information that you've been able to give your assistant group or just in preparation?
You know, I think, you know, the film speaks for itself. I don't think it's anything extra. I think, like I said, they're a tough, hard-nosed team that's disciplined, that's going to play hard. All the pillars of a good football team. So, if anything, it's just, you know, relating to the guys, what you see on film is what you're going to get. And hopefully, you know, for us, we understand how serious that means. But based on what I've seen for us in practice, we'll continue to work to get these guys ready for Saturday.
KB, you going to be upstairs? You're going to be on the sidelines this year. And what are you like as a coach on game day, being able to communicate with your players, whether you're either on the sideline or up in the booth?
On the sideline, I think, you know, I just think you talk about game day. I think, you know, one of the things that you try to do as a coach is instill the confidence throughout the course of the week, and then you're there kind of as the corner man once the game starts. If you're doing a ton of coaching on game day, that's probably a little bit of an issue, but there's always going to be adjustments to things that come up, or just things that you're seeing from the sideline that you can reiterate to the guys to make sure they're on task. I try not to be a huge yeller and screamer, you know, and I really don't do that at practice. I think during the course of the week, we try to get these guys ready, and then on Saturday, it's their time to have fun and our time to make sure the stuff that we've put in place works.
I know that you weren't here last year. When we talk with coaches about George being healthy, it is also super exciting. How excited are you to just be able to approach a season where he's not rehabbing an injury, he's not doing more maintenance and building and stuff like that?
Yeah, it's
it's always just so interesting because you talk to everybody outside and it's always like, well, George is always this, he's always that. And, you know, I don't, like I said, it's about confidence, it's about self-esteem, and I approach him with the fact of, you know, him being able to go out there and execute the skills we have for him. I don't really think about or talk about, you know, him being whatever happened in the past. Because, you know, just like, you know, after this game, we're going to be a new football team. Just after last season, this is a new football team. So George is attacked, like I said, the offseason and going into this game exactly how we wanted. I'm excited for him to be successful. No different than the rest of the guys that have put out all the work into going from January until now to get ready for this game. But, you know, I'm excited for him to go out there and lay his heart out like he would, you know, would have done last year if he was healthy all the time. But I'm excited to get him rolling.
You mentioned being a new season, new team. How big is the first game? Like, this to set the tone for the season? I mean, you've been a part of a lot of season openers. Is there something special about that first game where if you win, it kind of gets you rolling and get on track?
Yeah, I just think, you know, you get tired of going against each other. You get tired of the off season, and you go through the week, and then you get ready, and it's Monday again, and now, you know, you start to kind of zero in and target, okay, now we got a different opponent that we're facing. I think the big thing that we have to understand is going into the game, make sure we stick to what we're good at, you know, being poised and making sure we understand how we attack the field and our schemes, and not letting, you know, the anxiety and all the excitement of the first game get you out of whack. But of course, you know, the first game is always going to be big. You know, it's definitely gives you a line of where you're at moving into the rest of the season as you get started.
How's your group working with them?
Good. I mean, obviously the O-line and the D-line is those trench dogs, man. Those are the guys that, start the journey. First of all, the offense and how the team goes. Been very, confident in what those guys have been able to do. Like you said, we've got some veteran savvy guys that understand, you know, what it is to go out there and play this first game, what it is to go through practice after practice as you go through fall camp. As a running back and a running back coach, I mean, you always want to have a good relationship with the O-line. You know, make sure those guys are communicating with you. Make sure those guys are, keeping things plugged up for you up front as you get the ball handed off to you. But I'm excited, not only just for the O-line, but just the offense as a whole and really just the team. You talk about the culture and the vibe that Andy has kind of put together, and it's fun, it's exciting, and here we go, 2022.